get started, just want to introduce a couple more people that are in the front now. We have Anthony Oliveira, he is with our product marketing team. We also have Greg Swartz, he can answer any of your EV charging and partnership questions. And then we have Valda Stepanon, and he is with our advanced powertrain team, and he can answer anything that goes a little more technical for you. So with that, we'll open it up.
Is this a world car?
It is.
Do you expect the United States or China to be the largest market for it?
I do not know. I don't have that information.
And was this car designed with America in mind? As far as its design looks, its size, where it's going to place in your lineup?
Yes, it was.
But what are the possibilities for a long-range version, and why bZ4X and why not RAV4 electric? You have great brand awareness with RAV4. You had RAV4 electric in the past. What's the thinking there?
Which question?
Okay, great. Range, we're looking at future options. So this is what we think is competitive now, but we're definitely looking into that.
And then in terms of bZ4X, it really represents our entry into the BEV space, and we think we can do that with the bZ4X. The name's fantastic. We're looking into different things in the future, exploring the possibilities.
What are the charging times? So if you're at 10%, about 80% for each of the two drive areas?
Okay, so front wheel drive and all wheel drive will have from low fuel to 80% on the DC within the hour, 1 hour.
That's on the front wheel drive?
Both, front wheel drive and all wheel drive.
I have a couple of questions. I actually have to piggyback on this one. Can you just tell us how many kilowatts I can charge this at?
Say again?
How many kilowatts does it take in as DC charging?
We peak the front wheel drive at 150 and the all wheel drive at 100. But again, both within the hour will get 80.
Okay. My original questions were, since it made sense to make a bespoke platform, which is why it's not part of the RAV4. It makes more sense to make a bespoke platform for EV. Why don't you have a front? And why did you pick front wheel drive as your single motor option versus rear wheel drive?
Do you want to take that?
Yeah.
We chose front wheel drive versus rear wheel drive as we feel that's the best transition for our customers. Knowing that this is that seamless transition into BEV, that's what our customers are used to, so that's why we decided on front wheel drive. In regards to the front question, we believe there's ample storage space within the cabin itself, and we wanted to provide additional safety security in the front, as you'll see the sturdiness of the platform in order to do that. So.
We do have a platform for you to take a look at that's outside.
Are there any other questions?
You mentioned OTA capability. Not quite the same. Just to be, is there any way to clarify that? You will be doing OTA updates?
We will be doing OTA updates, and that will be for both safety features as well as multimedia features.
Also, do you have costs for the services that are being offered after the trial period?
We can provide that to you afterwards. The numbers are jumbled. So I'll provide that afterwards. Yep.
Lisa, you had said last night you were going to start your rollout with the ZEV states, and then you were going to expand nationally. Go over that timing again.
Sure. We will start with ZEV states as a priority, but we estimate that in the fall timeframe will be nationwide.
And do you have any sales estimates?
Yes, so we're estimating in 2022 calendar year, this first year, will be about 7,000 units and then increasing from there.
You know, trim level popular, what you expect to be the most popular sort of formula?
Yeah, so we're estimating right now all-wheel drive at about 60%, front-wheel drive at about 40%, and in terms of the split between the XLE and the Limited, 35%, 65%. I'm getting a nod for Anthony, so I didn't miss anything. All right.
Any special leasing rates to get people in this vehicle as quick as possible?
At this time, we don't have anything to announce.
Cynthia, could you go through the bZ4X explanation again? Four is size, X is...
Yeah, so bZ is beyond zero, right? You want to make sure our goal is to exceed more than near zero emissions. The four is size, and then the X...
Size being, four is a mid-size?
Yeah.
Okay.
And then X being that it's an SUV, the type of vehicle that it is.
And what's the voltage of the platform?
Excuse me?
What's the voltage of the platform? It's 400 volt? 355. Thanks. And maximum 150 kilowatt charge.
Well, the trouble got that. Is there a kilowatt hour limit to the free charging?
No. So first year, any customer that buys the bZ4X will have unlimited free charging.
Cool. And on the four in the nameplate, so we can expect a bZ5X, a bZ3X. That's future product, don't flat me, but I'm sure there's a plan to that.
We don't have anything that we can announce at this time, but it is conceivable that there would be other vehicles within that bZ.
Do you consider this one a mid-size, not a compact?
Small SUV.
Small SUV.
This is how we classify it. Let me clarify my answer. When I said unlimited for free charging the first year, that's at EVgo public stations.
Okay. EVgo, all right.
You discussed the marketing plan, but I'm wondering about what kind of legs you see it having. So often we've seen battery electric vehicles come in the market, there's a big splash initially, and then it drops off, and presumably sales drop off. And, you know, because you're also trying to promote the notion of battery electric, not only, you know, just the vehicle itself. What's your future plan?
Sure. Well, address it briefly and then invite Anthony to share any plans, but you make a really good point that with BEVs there's an educational component too. So in addition to the task we have when we launch any new vehicle, creating that awareness with BZ, because it is an electric vehicle, there's some consumer education that has to go along with it. So that will all be part of our marketing plan. And we do see that many components of it will be evergreen, because there is that awareness to build, and there is education that needs to take place with the consumer, and that, of course, won't happen overnight.
Just to further the point there, education is one of the key aspects that we have for this, to make this really that seamless transition. Today we have toyota.com/electrify/charging to have that charging resources. We're looking to amp that up, sorry for the pun, coming not only during the campaign but after as well, to make sure that we bring that momentum, and also making sure that everyone is educated on this, not just customers but everyone, so we can have bZ4X continue.
Kind of continuing on Cynthia's question, Anthony, you and I were talking about this last night, that the target demo here is over 100,000, which is high for Toyota. I wonder if you could talk to Toyota versus Lexus here. A lot of brands in the market, Polestar, Cadillac, Jaguar, are looking at an all-electric premium play for luxury. You guys are rolling out the Toyota EV before Lexus EV. Can you just talk about how those demographics cross?
Yeah, so there is a fair amount of differentiation between, obviously, the brands, how they go to market, the vehicles themselves. I think one of the things that you'll see overall with Toyota's approach, Toyota side and Lexus side, is our portfolio approach to electrification. So it isn't a one-size-fits-all solution, as I mentioned. So we have options for hybrid buyers. We have options for battery electric now with bZ, plug-in hybrids in here in California, hydrogen fuel cell. So there is a fair amount of differentiation on how we approach the market versus other brands, and then between Toyota and Lexus.
Do you have a greater percentage of electrification in Toyota than Lexus? Yeah, you talk a lot about 15% in Toyota. Is that higher than Lexus?
You know what? I would have to check and get back to you exactly what the split is.
You had mentioned that the charging station can be packaged with the purchase of the car. How much is that?
So the at-home charger is $699.
And who are who's the customer? Where are they coming from?
I can take that. Who is the customer? We, you know, as we were discussing yesterday, it's actually 35 to 55, and this is our key demographic, $100,000 plus as a household income. We actually call them the sensible futurist. They may not be that early adopter, but they want to be part of that early majority, really excited to be part of the EV landscape, but they also want it from a brand they trust. That's really why the Toyota bZ4X is well equipped for their needs. So.
And one last question. Will you be will dealers buy these cars, or will customers have to pre-order? What's that process going to look like?
It'll be normal distribution, normal sales process.
We'll take one.
You don't want to edit this one. My apologies in advance. Will all Toyota electric vehicles be bZ going forward?
Oh, so that's future product, which we're not going to comment on. But I think the big takeaway is there will be more BEVs in our future, in our lineup. That will only increase. BEVs are a huge part of our future, delivering on carbon neutrality, and then again, giving consumers a variety of options for electrified vehicles.
This may be an answer question. If you consider, or are you working with anybody like ChargeWay as far as education for the dealers and the consumers?
In terms of education, that's where actually Cynthia hurts.
Oh, Cynthia, pardon.
So we have a full-on strategy of what we're rolling out with the dealers. We actually just a month ago trained all of our regional trainers and our vehicle product trainers. We think that foundationally they need to have an understanding of how electricity even works, right? I think that coming into this landscape, everybody is at a different level of understanding. Which is why we're also building a lot of different assets, both video and publication. You can actually go to twitter.com/electrified/charging and find It's Electrifying, where we teach foundation of how electricity works, as well as how to charge a BEV. So education, again, like Anthony said, not just for our dealer body, but absolutely everyone, from consumers to our dealers.
Okay.